Once again, Lahul, good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah, we wish you a warm welcome to our 2016 series CFP video, CFP learning conference. I am delighted that today is Sunday, and when I say 9 o'clock you have to come, definitely many of people, when they heard 9 o'clock, they find difficult. But I am happy that we have a 30 odd participant with us. Definitely another 10 participant will join. But you have shown the real learning attitude and participating today early morning 9 o'clock. So I warm welcome, I am very happy. And the objective of this conference is to have a get together of our participants, because there are many participants, specifically those who are enrolled with me in video learning, okay, completed CAP, but I am meeting first time. Okay, so like Sanjay Gupta, he has specially came from Firozabad, small town from UP, okay, completed in January 2015 his CFP, but I am meeting first time. So that is the objective, that those participants have successfully completed CFP, those who have enrolled their CFP certification, video learning process, and this is the opportunity to not only meet with me, but there are some 30 odd like-minded professional, because Varun Tyagi know very well me, but he may not know about the way part up. So this is the opportunity where this high quality, you can say best personal finance professional, those who are working for client in Delhi, okay, or in and around Delhi, they can meet, they can interact, even they can create a, you can say one kind of association and meet regularly also for benefit of the community. So I once again welcome. Now let's move into the agenda. Because we have to start at 10 o'clock, but it is 9:54, so we are starting as per schedule. Our conference, you can say title, Logical and Magical 5 Step to Achieve 100 Crore Plus AUM. I would like to say, out of you, how many are the full-time IFA? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Sanjay is also, so almost we have 50% are the IFA, I know my all participants. So before we move into the conference agenda, let's decide the ground rules, because we are here from 10 to evening 6 o'clock, so we need to follow the ground rules to ensure that we learn, exchange best practices, we basically network with the other participants. So first and foremost, phone switch off or silent physically and mentally in the conference. Once you decided to participate in the conference, okay, so in case if you are getting any call, we will be having enough break. We will have a first tea break at 12 o'clock, then we will have a second break 2 o'clock for lunch for 45 minutes, then we have another break in evening 4:30 for tea coffee. So we will be having enough time to basically attend the missed call or the call we have missed. So I request, keep your mobile switch off or silent physically and mentally in the conference. Please come in time post break. Be a student to listen and learn. Because as an adult professional, when you want to learn, we have to basically keep, then no one can insert the new thoughts or new concepts, new things to in your mind. So if you give 20-30% space to your mind, so automatically new thought will come, and this new thought may give you a better performance in your professional or better results in your personal career. Note down the important points of speaker, because Sandeep Singhalji is one of the senior professionals, but even if he want to improve his professional advisory, so today he'll get the chance, when he listen full day 8 to 10 speakers, so he gets the maybe a minimum 8 to 10 new points, so that he can basically start discussing or start implementing from tomorrow. Participate and ask the question. So I have one beautiful memento, or you can say gift, for all participants, provided you follow above rules and attend the full day conference. So this is the beautiful rural pen is there, which is the mentioned certified financial planner. So those who are CFP certificate, they will feel proud when they are using with their clients or discussion with the client. Those who are CFP aspirant, they get inspiration and motivation. Yes, okay, now I have to complete my journey of CFP certification on a priority basis. So that's how this gold pen is, you can say, invaluable gift for all of you. You can say comfort zone. I know that when we have started the conference in the morning, all of you are sitting at different places, okay, and without any physically friend or maybe colleague, etc. So I have a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 tables are in place. I request if you can join one of the table. So we have a 6 round table with us, 6 group with us. I request that I am giving you 5 to 7 minute time. I request you introduce each other about yourself, if your name, your you can say professional background, personal background, okay, why you are attending the conference, okay, what is the motivation to attend the conference, and give the name of the group. Aapko kya karna hai, you have to give the name of your group, and during the day you have to make sure that your group has to ask one question for one speaker. So let's say we have 10 speakers, and each speakers when he or she will present for 20 to 25 minutes presentation, it is expected that when you have learned or when you have understood something, definitely there must be some question. Yes or no? Question is good or bad?
Yes.
It is good, because if someone is learning, then question arises. If someone is not learning, okay, then question doesn't arise. So you have to basically name the group, and you have to ensure that you have to also decide one leader for the group. Okay, leader means one representative for the group, and that representative basically, either if participant doesn't want to ask directly question, he can ask, or he can basically give the question to the representative if he finds any basically you can say uncomfortable. Sometimes participant, someone may not find comfortable to asking the question, okay, in public forum. So you can hand over that question to your representative. He will ask. As a representative or leader, you have to note down the question. And end of the day, when there are 10 speakers, when there are 10 questions your group has asked, you will hand over to me, and we'll give a surprise gift to the best group. Hum kya karenge? जो बेस्ट ग्रुप होगा, जिन्हें एक अच्छा वैल्यूएशन किया है, जिन्होंने एक क्वालिटी क्वेश्चन पूछे हैं, जिसे ये फोरम का जो हमारा ऑब्जेक्टिव है, लर्न एक्सचेंज द बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस, ओके, इंटरेक्ट विद द कंस्ट्रक्टिव डिस्कशन एंड टू अचीव द नेक्स्ट लेवल, टू प्रोवाइड आवर एडवाइजरी टू आवर कस्टमर्स. सो आई एम गिविंग यू 5 टू 7 मिनट टाइम. आई एम श्योर दैट ऑल ऑफ यू आर गेटिंग माय थॉट. यस और नो?
यस.
सो आई एम गिविंग यू 5 टू 7 मिनट टाइम to start interacting with your group member, okay, and note down the all group member name down the your group, okay, and then end of the each speaker, you have to make sure that each group must have asked one question, quality questions, and group which will ask the best questions, okay, that will decide. Me and Mr. Raj from Motilal Oswal will decide which is the best group, and will give the surprise gift to the all 5 or 6 member of the group. So time to you. You
you can come here.
हेलो फिनिश एक्टिविटी यस एंजॉयड एक्टिविटी यस और नो
वही जाओ
रजनी जी
वही जाओ
टीम डिसाइडेड द टीम एज परिवर्तन एंड वी फाइव आई एम संदीप सिंगल सर्टिफाइड फाइनेंशियल प्लानर and independently doing my profession.
Yes,
and,
you can use my
my friend Mr. Haminder Gar, he is also CFP and he is with ICICI Securities as a trainer. And Ms. Swati, she is also at CFP and Mr. Mr. Varun Tyagi, he is also CFP and 7 years you have completed and Mr. Rajni, he is a chartered accountant. Thank you.
Good morning everyone.
Good morning.
The name of our group is Revolution and the members, respective members of the group are Mr. Utkarsh, an independent financial advisor, Sanjay Gupta ji, an independent financial advisor, then Mr. Manish Thakur, again a banker,
working with them,
ji, Manoj Malik, again with one of the reputed bankers, and I am CA intermediate, and I am currently pursuing CFA level. Thank you.
What about CFP?
CFP, though it is.
Okay.
Yeah.
Insurance professional.
Your name?
Rahul Anand.
Rahul Anand. Yes.
I'm an insurance professional. I just joined last year mutual fund industry MFI.
Okay. What is your group name? After
the
group.
Yes. He will represent the group.
Okay.
Warrior.
Okay. Warrior. Okay.
Yeah, we are a group of warriors and Mr. Ashish Sharma and Mr. Abhishek Shukla and Mr. Rahul Anand and myself Piyush Padia, we are four in this group. Ashish is already working as a IFA, Abhishek is also working as a IFA, Rahul has joined this industry last year and I am into the mortgages industry, I am from the mortgages industry. So we are here to learn more, to come aggressively in this field.
Perfect.
Thank you. Please pass this.
The group name is Achievers. We are a group of three. We are Achievers.
and I am a CA intern as well, and I'm working with Deloitte standard department, and I've joined the video learning also. We have Mr. Aditya Chauhan, he's an independent financial advisor. Mr. Vivek Patel is a certified financial planner. So I'm sitting in a group with senior professionals. So this is great. So thank you.
Plus crore AUM. Today we know that
कि पीपल आर मूविंग फ्रॉम प्रोडक्ट्स टू अ बेसिकली गोल बेस्ड फाइनेंशियल प्लानिंग एंड दे बेसिकली फोकस मोर ऑन टू द AUM एसेट अंडर मैनेजमेंट. सो मोर द एसेट आई एम मैनेजिंग द क्लाइंट आई कैन अर्न मोर इनकम. You can charge even fee also. There are many organization or people, they charge upfront to the client on a AUM, maybe starting from 0.5% to 1% 2%, or you can earn from your manufacturer. Like in mutual fund, we know there is a concept of tail income. So if someone has a 10 crore AUM, on average, if I consider 0.5 also, so one can generate the 5 lakh rupees income by only providing the quality service to the client. So without additional business, you are generating, for example, 5 lakh rupees minimum income. So that's how we will learn how to achieve the 100 crore AUM, setting up a fee-based advisory, how we can establish our fee-based advisory. If I quickly show you the agenda, he is a CFP practitioner. He has completed CFP in January 2015 with A grade 75% plus. Today he is a full time independent advisor. Then second speaker, Abhishek Rastogi, could not come due to some personal reason. Second speaker will be Mr. Varun Tyagi. He is also a CFP certificant and full time independent advisor. We will have a Mr. Raj from Motilal Oswal AMC. He will share AMC philosophy, buy type, sit type. We have one, two senior professionals, you can say senior IFA and CFP practitioner, Mr. Vivek Pathak. He is a CFP practitioner, very senior professional, worked with 10 years plus with bank, and company name is Finance and You. Mr. Sandeep Singhalji, he is also one of the senior professional, senior independent financial advisor. Then we have a Sumit Prabhakar, couldn't reach, so I am not discussing. Mr. Manish Thakur is there, he is working with Indusind Bank as a wealth manager. Avinash Banga will come, he is also a senior wealth management professional. We have Swati Sethi. She is also a CFP certificate, pursuing right now MBA and CFA USA. She will share her success story, how she has completed CFP. Rahul Bevari will talk about something different, CA, MBA, the
world
beyond the CA. Yeah. Because normally...
World beyond statutory courses.
Okay, world beyond statutory courses. Good, good, very good.
Yes.
So we know that in our country, people adhere to statutory courses like CA or maybe CS or MBA is already, you can say, by default statutory, because if you are graduate, then if you are not doing anything, then do it MBA. So Rahul will share. We have two more participants. Sangeet Malikji is very senior professional, but unfortunately his health is not well. So I am not sure he will join, but we have two young participants. One is Hemant Goel, he is a completed one exam and aspiring independent financial advisor. Ishan Agrawal, he is also entered CA, working with Deloitte, Gurgaon. So basically our objective that we have a 10 plus speakers, they are like you only and they are sitting with you only. We don't have a different sitting arrangement. Speaker. Reason is being that they have done something one step beyond the normal person and again they are in process to achieve the next level. Understand the benefit before going for the benefit of CFP certification, let understand the curriculum CFP. So as we know that in our country agency business is considered or was considered, I am not talking about today's term, but it was considered as a last option. Okay, suppose in Gujarat, example, or Rajasthan, where they don't go to army because they find themselves uncomfortable going and joining the army. Okay, so what they do, they take it a agency in life insurance or post office. So agency, when example as a graduate or as a you can say middle class person, if I couldn't get any opportunity, then what was the last option? It was used as a agency. So in our country, agency is evolved as a business where I am pushing a product to my client, and when I am pushing the product, I am giving you a rebate. Even if I am a post office agent, if I am getting a 2% commission, I say that 1% I will give you. When there was no competition against the LIC in 1990s, okay, or 1980s, even the rebate was a rampant practice. One lady, her name Anuya Purwal, she joined in 1994 with LIC, and she was found that without rebate in Mumbai, she was unable to do business. Giving a rebate, it was a basic requirement. So pushing a product, and if client is not ready with push, then you give a rebate. So now this kind of culture was of the agency business or product. Now we are moving from that culture to different culture, so definitely it will take time. So if we have knowledge, if we have skill sets, then we can not only basically avoid the rebate, but we can charge the fee to the client. So here at this juncture, we are learning such a way that we will not give rebate first in any product. Second, instead of rebate, we will charge the fee for our advice. So when you want to charge the fee, or when you earn from the client, upfront fee from the client, definitely you have more knowledge and skill set. So that knowledge and skill set come from the, that is a one certification, which is known as a Certified Financial Planner. It is a US-based certification. It was evolved in 1980 in US. Today, it is present in 25 plus countries, and approximately 150,000 plus professionals are there across the world in 25 countries. But unfortunately, in India, our regulator believes in minimum standard. For getting the life insurance, go for life insurance agency. Earlier, it was 100-hour training. Then there was a demand, reduce the man hours because we are not getting more agent, converted to 50%, 50 hours training. Then there was demand that 50% pass percent is too high, reduced to 34%. And now I heard that they empowered to conduct the exam in their offices. Now you can understand that if this is the culture of our country, when you recruit the new advisor or new agent, how can you expect the quality? So when we expect the minimum standard, definitely the good person who want to be really be a want to looking for a career, but he'll struggle and he'll build the agency business. So today the highest attrition is there in life insurance business. You can say if 100 agents come in the bucket, you will find end of the 1 year 90 will move out because of the proper structure is missing. So here we are talking about the maximum standard. What we are talking? Maximum standard. So when we are talking of maximum standard, so definitely CFP certifications will help us to achieve the maximum standard. So instead of pushing the product, we will identify and prioritize the short term, medium term, long term goal. When I sit with my client, I prepare what are your short term, medium term, long term goal. Maybe short term goal, maybe buying a car, buying a house, medium term for children higher education, maybe children marriage, long term maybe a retirement. I'm just giving an example. So once we identify the goal, we calculate how much inflation adjusted corpus required for each goal. We know we are living in a country where there is a 5-6% inflation. So today if I required 5 lakh rupees, after 20 years I require much more than 5 lakh rupees because of the inflation. I may require maybe 20 lakh rupees, example. But if I don't know, then I will plan for how many rupees? 5 lakh only. Then I will find it in trouble. So we help client to calculate the inflation adjusted corpus for each goal, educating about the goal-based asset allocation strategy, deciding the right return for each goal, calculating investment required, suggesting suitable product to achieve each goal, implementation and regular review. So that's how this is the heart of the certification. Apart from, or you can say, what could be the goal can be included: retirement planning, children's higher education planning, children's marriage planning, vacation planning, insurance planning, house or car planning, donation planning, etc. So what are the benefits of learning this CFP certification? So first and foremost benefit, building a high quality knowledge and skill set in personal finance. Okay, so when you are a full-time independent advisor and if you want to avoid the rebate and charge the fee, then you have to do it. Okay, if you are a corporate employee working in HDFC Bank as a relationship manager, I am taking this example. Okay, HDFC Bank will tell you, or your boss will tell you what to achieve. They will never talk about how to achieve. This is your MBA, we are hired from campus, we are giving you a good salary, okay, 4-5 lakh rupees package as a relationship manager, wealth manager. Now it is your job, go and do it for us. So, when you completed your graduation, post-graduation, and you joined the bank as a relationship manager in any private sector bank, you were not exposed to the personal finance product. You were never gone through the what is mutual fund, what is the asset allocation, okay. And now again, next day onwards, you have a target to achieve. So, if I know that the relationship management in bank is a good job profile, but if I don't know how to achieve, then I will find myself in problem. So today, if I can say in HDFC Bank also, if they hire 100 relationship manager, example, I am talking name only, in any private sector bank, or if I say the total private sector bank, they hire a relationship manager or wealth manager, private banker, 100, okay, you will find 80 will out of after 1 year, because they were asked to achieve the targets, they were not discussed or not trained how to achieve the targets, or they were not exposed to the basically how to sell, or they not having the enough skill set. So those who are even into full-time advisory with corporate, if they achieve, they would find more comfort and they will be able to deliver their results, and they can do a win-win situation, win for company, win for the client. So we learn and master the goal-based financial, family financial planning, learn to prepare the comprehensive financial plan for your client. We can double our acquisition, advisory and retention skill, multiply our AUM. Okay, if we ask Sandeep ji before 3 years, okay, what was your target after 3 years? Where do you see what would be the AUM? He might have told from 1 crore to 10 crore, but today he is at 50 crore. So how it has happened, definitely he will share in detail. So that's how we can multiply our AUM, push to pull, product distributor to financial coaching. Nobody like to push product. We want to pull the business. So how we can pull the business when we are treat ourselves as a financial coach? So when you say, I am your financial coach, not even advisor. So client will give you more trust, more respect, and it will lead to a more result. So it is a win-win situation, happiness, long-term relationship. So these are the key benefit I have shared. For the benefit, I just took a one simple case. If I show you, okay, what could be the case study. CFP certification, this is the one of the standard case study. Okay, when I sit with the client, I prepared the 2-page case study about example Mr. Ashwin, their family members, their income, their assets and liability, their expense, their important goals and assumption to achieve the goal. So at one point Mr. Ashwin told me in goal number 3, he informed me that retirement corpus at Ashwin age 60 to sustain the same lifestyle to their expected lifetime. So I just so we have a data for benefit of you. I have mentioned data. Ashwin is age of 34, Sumedha is age of 31, wants to know monthly CIP required to build inflation adjusted retirement corpus. Post retirement corpus will be invested in debt fund. Okay, definitely we know that post retirement we need a steady withdrawal, so we can't take a risk. So I consider as a debt fund. Debt fund return is 7%, inflation is 5%. I consider throughout the tenure
Life expectancy 80 and 82, retirement age is 60, and monthly expense is 40,000. Now, there are two options I have. First, I can open up an Excel sheet and I say, okay, Mr. Ashwin, you have a monthly household expense of 40,000. This 40,000 at age of 60 because of inflation will become a 1,42,227 rupees per month, and to withdraw 1,42,226 every month, increasing at the 5% in post-retirement period, you require how much corpus of 3,40,43,365 rupees. Okay? And if we target the average return in pre-retirement period 12%, return will SIP required is how much? 17,737. This is the first approach, and this approach is only used by 10% people. 90% people, even in market, they don't use this approach also. They just piece the product and link with the need of retirement. So they don't share the detail. So now, what would be the second approach? So second approach is pen and paper. Second approach says, Mr. Sanjay, your age of 34, your spouse is age of 31, pre-retirement period is 26, at age 60 you would like to retire, post-retirement return is 7%, post-retirement inflation is 5%, so cost today is 40,000 will become a 1,42,227, and if you want to increase, because we need an increasing annuity, every year that 1,42,227 must increase 5% every year to compensate the inflation in post-retirement period. So we require this corpus. And you show the steps how the corpus is arrived. This is the first step. Find future value of present value 1,42,227. For increasing annuity, we have considered the concept of ROR, and this how corpus is arrived. 3,40,43,387. So now tell me, you have a two approach. This is the first approach and this is the second approach. Which as a client will find better?
Second one. Will be more.
First or second?
Second.
Because second, first, here there is a only a text-based version is there, and we know that 90% people are the visual people. When you give the image, okay, they learn faster and better. So when we created the image, this is the your retirement timeline, this is the steps, and this is the corpus is arrived. So the understanding, the you can say buying about the investment would be far better or higher. So then you will not need to worry about the SIP. So today those participants have completed CFP and started applying timeline based approach. So earlier they were getting the arbitrary ticket size in mutual fund business, let's say 2,000, 5,000 ticket size, then they started getting the required ticket size, maybe 15,000, 20,000 per month, and now client is not worried about the short term problem in market. Client knows that I want to withdraw my value at which date? After 26 years. So why should I worry about today? If I am in Delhi right now and some problem arises in Mumbai, I need not to worry because I am not in Mumbai, I am in Delhi, so I am need not to worry. But many of time what happened that when I don't have a clarity, then I end up with the unnecessary worry and I withdraw my investment. So when we find that when any client or investor withdraws the investment because he is not clear about the goal, so when he is not clear of goal, he invests in bullish run and he exit in bearish run, and that's how he will end up with the capital loss. But if you are a learned investor, or if you have given education to your client, it will be win-win situation for both client and advisor. So now again, once we have acquired, calculated the corpus, 3,40,43,387,
I have not talked about the asset class, which asset class you will invest. I say that if you are expecting 6% return on your investment, you go to the, I am considering post-tax return, because we know that the fixed deposit, there is a recurring deposit, the element of tax. So I am considering average post-tax return in long term, which is the 6%. So what is the per month investment is required? 46,000. 460. If you find yourself, you can invest for retirement goal, only for the which goal? Retirement goal. Because as a family, they have many goals. They have a surplus of 50,000, but they cannot invest their 50,000 for the one surplus, one goal. Nah? Suppose I have a 5 goal in list, one short term, two medium term, one long term. So I have to divide 50,000 among the 5 goals, because all 5 goals for me important. And now I find that for one goal I have to invest 46,000, 460. So if client find that yes, I have only one goal and I can afford, yes, go and enjoy. Take it risky investment, okay, example. But if you find difficult, you don't have money, okay, so if sufficient surplus, then you have to progress in the risk. You can go for debt fund, 34,000, 25, 10% return, average I can say, 25,000. If you go for the 12% return, what is the investment is required? 17,738 per month. So we know that almost one third investment is required if you compare 6% versus the 12%. But client must got education. When I go for the equity link product, either direct equity, I do mutual fund, there is a volatility risk in short term. But if I am committing with the good stock broker, okay, like Motilal Oswal, or I am committing with the good AMC for a long term with supervision of the my relationship manager or fund manager, it gives me indirect guarantee of achieving the 12% return. So I need not to take a, any worry by investing 17,738. So our objective is that we need not to be a brand ambassador of any asset class. Client has to decide, if I have money, go and invest in risky instrument. But if you don't have money, then where you have to invest? Into a risk asset class. So in our country, we know that it is a already an underemployed country. Under opportunities are there in our country. So you will find 10 out of 9 family, I can say minimum, they will have a more per month requirement. Okay, and they have maybe 1/5 or 1/10 only surplus. Suppose someone required 1 lakh rupees investment per month to achieve the 5 important goal of life, but they have only 10-20,000 surplus. Then what they need to do? Unko kya karna hoga? Compulsory risk lena hoga na? Calculative risk with help of the fund manager. If I go one step ahead and educate client, cost of delay or procrastination. Aaj ki date mein humne sahi knowledge de diya. Client को समझ में आ गया कि मुझे 17,738 invest करना है per month to achieve the goal. But कई बार client delay करते हैं, तो हम उसको educate करते हैं कि भाई आप 5 साल delay करते हैं. If you delay your investment 5 years and instead of SIP for 26 years, you do a SIP for 21 years. What is the SIP required? 32,640. If you delay another 5 years and if you have an investment period of only 16 years, instead of 2034, I start my planning for retirement at 44. So 44 to 60, how many years are there? Only 16 years there. So what is the SIP is required? Only 62,000, almost 4 times. And if I wake up in last 11 years, how much SIP is required? 1,29,000. So it is known that the CMPD, compounding interest, is known as the 8th wonder of life. 8th wonder of world. Okay, compounding interest is known as the 8th wonder of the world. Those who use in their favor, they create a wealth. And those who do opposite, they pay the debt. Because those who take a loan, pay the EMI, and end of their life, they may not have any wealth. Sometimes they find themselves in debt trap also. So that's how, if you start early and if you stay invested for long period, you have a very less requirement to achieve the particular goal. Now, your client says that 17,000 is not affordable to me. My goal is realistic, 3 crore 43 lakh. but even 17,000 is not affordable. Can we show any alternate, any option to the client? Yes,
yes
or no?
Yes,
very good. So we can show the increasing SIP. In our country, till date, after 20 years of private mutual fund, SIP is still a new concept. When they are promoting SIP, they are promoting like it's a something new. Okay? But I say the CFP certificate, the SIP is a obsolete concept. You have to promote the increasing SIP. Because today it is not possible that I can start the 17,738 rupees or 18,000 odd SIP when my salary is example or net income is 50,000 for one goal. And again we know that any individual is expected to earn at least 7 to 8% over a period of time every year. There is an inflation, there is a salary growth also, na? Income growth. So I have to suggest the which SIP? Increasing SIP. So I have calculated, I will not share in detail. So if I consider if you have suggested client to invest example 12,000 rupees per month and that 12,000 rupees SIP increase 5% every year. SIP growth is 5% every year. So first year it is 12,000, then 5% of 12,000 is approximately you can say 600 rupees. So 12,600, then 13,200 something. So when your SIP will increase 5% compounded over the previous installment, you will be able to achieve the goal. So instead of 17,000 odd SIP, your 5,686 cost is saved. So how much savings? 32%. If you increase 7%, this is realistic. We can say we expect average salary growth of 7%. So you can have only 10,000 rupees SIP requirement. So how much in rupee terms you can save? 7,665 and the 43% savings. If you are going for 10%, if you find that my income will grow in a 10%, or I can pay contribution every year by increasing 10%, then your SIP is required only 7,500 rupees odd. So almost 60 odd percent savings is there. So by doing a 7% increase in growth, we have reduced cost of SIP from 17,738 to 10,000. So we have make a goal affordable. मैं goal को क्या बना दिया? Affordable बता दिया ना? क्योंकि goal realistic था, but client afford नहीं कर सकता था, तो हमने increasing SIP से goal को हमने क्या कर दिया? Affordable कर दिया. So it is a job of the certified financial planner. आज के date में CFP के लिए I don't find कि कोई ये discuss कर सकता है. And it is necessary that कि everyone every year there is a growth in income. Then why it must not be a growth in investment? Okay? Suppose if I link as a family, I should save 30% of all my take home income. Suppose one family has a take home income of 1 lakh rupees and we have decided to save, advice to invest 30%, 30,000. Second year income is increased to 1,10,000. Now, if you have given an average SIP, fixed SIP, then SIP will not increase. You will start spending more money. So I can say that when your income is 1,10,000 next year, you invest 33,000 rupees. That's how growing SIP will help client to stick to the percentage of the savings also. It was just a standard retirement plan. We can add much more in retirement plan like recurring medical expense. Because we know that in young age we may not require any medical expense, but if we talk about our senior citizen, our parents, grandparents, and see that how much rupees we are spending per month for their medicines or OPD expenses, example, then that much we should also plan for our post-retirement expense, cushion for life expectancy, fund for hobbies, gift, donation, vacation, etc. When I retire, I will not like to sit in my home and watch television or read the newspaper. I like to do something different, or I want to do activities, but that activities require also money, na? So if I have not planned that money, how can I do that activity? How can I basically cultivate my hobbies? So I can plan for my hobbies, give whatever I can do. I want to do in post-retirement period. I have to plan today, and I have to know what is the corpus is required for the hobby fund or gift fund, donation, vacation, estate planning, and then accordingly I have to increase my save. We have to consider the lifestyle expenses. We, as a certified financial planner, present scenario into three ways. One is the moderate scenario, second is conservative, and third is aggressive scenario. Even we have to suggest the suitable asset allocation. When client is investing for long term, we can suggest that you should invest 60-70% in risk asset class like equity and 32% in safe asset class. Technical asset allocation 10% plus or minus. This is for the distribution stage reference to retirement. We can say that 70-80% you should invest into the safe asset class because you have to do regular withdrawal. But same time you can keep 20-30% risk asset class to get the good return. And technical asset allocation of 10% to take the benefit of volatility. Other important components like debt planning, lifestyle expense reduction planning, contingency planning, estate planning, tax planning, philanthropy planning, real estate planning. I take 2 minutes to discuss the concept of net worth. We know that net worth is assets minus liabilities. But if we check our client, you will find that the most of the so-called net worth are consumption net worth. I have, as a CFP practitioner, I have divided net worth into two parts. One is the consumption net worth and second is the non-consumption net worth. So consumption net worth which I am using, let's say I have a house, I am living that house, it is a consumption. I have a car, I have a second house, weekend house I call it. Again I am going for weekend. I have a basically some you can say gold jewelry or diamond jewelry. So again that jewelry is consumed by my spouse. So if we see in our country any case study, you will find that 80% of the assets are which assets?
Consumption
assets. So consumption assets are, honestly speaking, they are not assets, they are liabilities. If someone has a second car or second home, you don't get the rent, okay? But you have to ensure the proper maintenance of home, mandatory maintenance or maybe time to time renovation is required. So it is a liability, it is not asset. So that's how in our country, most of the people, they are creating a consumption assets. So we have to educate client, instead of consumption asset, you must create a non-consumption asset. So that non-consumption asset helpful to achieve your financial goal. For your retirement or your children higher education or your maybe vacation, etc. So in this case study, we found that the client has net worth of 51,65,000. Out of non-consumption net worth is how much? 6,65,000. It is just 10% of the your total assets. So when we are talking about consumption, we are not investing. It is a basically we are creating the liabilities.
Sir, example of non-consumption asset.
Example of non-consumption asset. Any asset you can sell it without any emotions. Okay, suppose I have a mutual fund or equity, and when money is required for certain event or uncertain event, I can sell without any worry. So it is a non-consumption. I have a house, okay, which is on a rental.
That generates
rent. Okay, generates income as well as if I have decided when I retire, I'll sell it. Okay, so non-consumption means if you are not using these assets. If you have a gold bar and you have a gold jewelry, the gold bar can be treated as a non-consumption asset. Na? I have an example, 100 gram gold bar. I cannot carry and show okay, this I have a gold bar, but jewelry is a consumption. So wife may not like to sell jewelry in case of normal contingency or event happen. But as a family, they may like to sell gold bar without any tension. Okay, this is for investment. So any asset one can sell when money is required to achieve the goal, it is known as a non-consumption asset. And asset you like to not to sell, like you have a car, if you sell it, then you will lose your comfort, you find yourself in trouble. आपको लगेगा आपका स्टेटस कम हो गया कार नहीं है तो एनी एसेट्स व्हिच में नॉट लाइक इन नॉर्मल कंडीशन इट इज अ और यू आर यूजिंग ऑलरेडी एसेट इट इज नोन एज अ कंजम्पशन एसेट्स अप्रोच वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस See, normally in our country today, most of the people are using push approach, where as a CFP practitioner, we use pull approach. Many of people talk about the first impression, but we talk about last impression. Okay, people do complex presentation, but we do simple presentation. People use Excel, PPT, we use pen, paper, computer in front of client to achieve their goal. People doing a product-based solution, we are doing a goal-based solution. Many of people in bank, they are transaction-oriented. When they sold one life insurance policy, they will not contact for 1 year. Okay, now we already sold, we'll contact next year. But we act as a financial coach to a family. Short-term versus long-term, higher commission versus client satisfaction or happiness. Recently, I came to know one private bank, leading private bank in Mumbai, they have on average 50 crore business month on month from their HNI client, because it is known as a wealth management division. So from HNI or NI client, 50 crore rupees month on month by selling 30 crore average capital protection plan of mutual fund. You know, capital protection plan gives up to 10% upfront commission because there is a lock-in period of 3 to 5 years. Second is the traditional life insurance. So we know it gives you up to 100% commission in first year to bank. So they only sell which product which gives the highest revenue. So here our objective is not to get the highest revenue, but we as a CFP practitioner, we have our own family. We have to also ensure the minimum lifestyle to our family. So we talk, we do a balance. So it is a win situation for client, win situation for the our client family also. Key benefit of comprehensive financial plan construction. Many of time client says that people are ready to give me a rebate, then why I should give a fee? People are ready to give me a rebate, then why should I give fee? I say that when you approach me, when you prepare your financial plan under my supervision as a CFP certificate, I help you first and foremost benefit to reduction in your lifestyle expense. You will think twice before you will spend. I met one private sector branch manager, okay, when he enrolled in training, and after the training, when we met, he said ki pehle main ek baar bhi sochta nahi tha kharch karne se pehle, abhi main do baar sochta hun, because now I realize how much corpus is required for my children's higher education, how much corpus is required for my retirement, because private bank is not going to offer a post-retirement income. So what happened that ki when there is a knowledge comes ki mujhe itna paisa chahiye future mein, to aaj main spend kar dunga, to main kahan se future mein paisa leke aaunga. Okay, so automatically it helps you to save more, spend less. So I can assure you ki you can reduce your monthly expense by minimum how much percentage? 10%. Kitni bhi aapki income hai, kisi ki 50,000 expense hai per month, kisi ki 5 lakh expense hai per month, but minimum how much you can save your expense? 10%. Suppose if one can save 5,000 per month expense, in a year it is a 60,000, and if I ask fee of 10,000, what is the problem? I am giving you first and foremost benefit. Ye toh mera kya hai? 25 benefit hai example, usme se kya hai? First and foremost, even you can reduce your lifestyle expenses. I will help you in proper debt planning. I will help you in interest rate reduction, debt reduction, new loan planning, and I will help you to be a debt free in 3 to 5 years. We know that in our country, when repo rate decreases, bank doesn't decrease the interest rate, na? Because unki profitability badhti hai na? Aaj unka cost of fund 9% se 8% ho gaya, aur wo humne client ko benefit denge to unko kya fayda? So that's the reason RBI has to intervene to reduce the interest rate. And we have seen that those who have taken a loan in 2010 at 8.5% interest rate in housing loan, it is increased to 12%. But if you check your right now, it might be 11.5%. But new loan rate is 9.5%. So you are paying 2% higher than the new investors. So suppose if you meet your existing client and if you say that I'll identify how many loans you have and I'll help you to reduce your interest rate. So after the training, many of my participants, they review their loan portfolio, go to a bank, negotiate and reduce their interest rate from 11.5 to maybe 10% or 10.5, say 9.5%. So now if outstanding principal is 10 lakh rupees and if one person is reduced, what is the benefit? is a 10,000 per annum. So that is another second benefit we can offer to our client. We help client to do a debt reduction. Many of times we find a client has a many debt instrument, fixed deposit, recurring deposit, post office fixed deposit, gold pada hai ghar pe, cash pada hai, aur saath mein kya chal rahi hai? पर्सनल लोन चल रही है, कार लोन चल रही है, तो हम उसको बता सकते हैं कि भाई आपके जो भी इंस्ट्रूमेंट के रेट लोन के रेट से कम है, यानी कि आपका ये इंस्ट्रूमेंट 8% अर्न करता है और आप कितना पे कर रहे हैं, 12% पे कर रहे हैं एग्जांपल, तो आपको क्या करना चाहिए? आपको पे ऑफ करना चाहिए ना, क्योंकि आप 1,00,000 के आउटस्टैंडिंग प्रिंसिपल पे 4,000 का नुकसान कर रहे हैं। बट वो कई बार क्लाइंट इमोशनली बता सकता है कि भाई मैं क्या करूंगा, ये पैसा मेरा ऐसा ही रहेगा और जो मैं ईएमआई पे करूंगा उससे मेरी वेल्थ बन जाएगी। बट मैं हम उसको लॉजिकल सॉल्यूशन दे सकते हैं कि फिर आप क्या करिए, जो ईएमआई आपका सेव होगा वो ईएमआई को आप आरडी में कन्वर्ट कर दीजिए ना। इफ यू आर अ रिस्क अवर्स इन्वेस्टर यू कैन इन्वेस्ट इन रिकरिंग डिपॉजिट, इफ यू आर अ रिस्क इन्वेस्टर यू कैन कन्वर्ट इनटू अ म्यूचुअल फंड इक्विटी इन्वेस्टमेंट फॉर लॉन्ग टर्म। बट इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी दैट इमोशनली आप देखेंगे कि मेरी नेटवर्थ है, because net worth is assets minus liabilities, it is not only assets. So if you pay off your liability, your net worth will be remain same, and whatever the EMI savings you can convert into the investment which will give you more result. So we make logic, we bring logic to our client and help client to be a debt free. We can help client to take a logical new loan also. Many of time people take a loan without thinking of repaying capacity, because today bank find housing loan is one of the safest loan for bank. So they may offer 60-70-80% of the income as a EMI. Bank ko to pata hai ki ye ghar jo hai uski value kya hai, wo kal ye vyakti pay nahi karega to hum recover kar lenge, because in our country they offer only 70-80% of loan. So one person can afford only 1 BHK, example, which is the cost 50 lakh rupees, but bank has given option, why don't you go for 2 BHK, we'll give you a 75 lakh loan. So by doing this, he's created 25 lakh debt, and that debt will translate into the higher EMI, and that higher EMI will take into the surplus. Aaj hamare paas koi income hai, net income hi nahi bachegi after paying EMI, so how can I fund my future growth? So hum client ko educate kar sakte hai ki aap ghar lena chahte hai, बट वो भी आपको नीड बेस देना चाहिए, आप अफोर्ड नहीं कर सकते, तो इट इज बेटर टू स्टे इन अ स्मॉल हाउस इंस्टेड ऑफ गोइंग अ बिग हाउस पेइंग अ हायर ईएमआई एंड बेसिकली क्रिएटिंग अननेसेसरी एक्सपेंसेस, बिकॉज इवन व्हेन यू हैव अ बिगर हाउस यू नीड टू पे अ हायर मेंटेनेंस, यू विल फाइंड योरसेल्फ इनटू हायर सोसाइटी और मे बी वेयर पीपल विल बी इन अ हायर देन यू इन स्टेटस, सो यू अगेन स्पेंड मोर मनी, तो आपके पास कुछ सरप्लस रहेगा नहीं। तो इसलिए हम क्लाइंट को कहते हैं कि बिगेस्ट एनिमी ऑफ एनी फैमिली, बिगेस्ट एनिमी ऑफ एनी फैमिली इज नॉट इन्फ्लेशन। तो क्या है आपका बिगेस्ट एनिमी? लाइफस्टाइल एक्सपेंसेस। बिगेस्ट एनिमी एक फैमिली का वो है लाइफस्टाइल एक्सपेंसेस, नॉट द इन्फ्लेशन। इन्फ्लेशन तो 5-6% से एवरेज बढ़ रहा है, ओके, तो आपकी इनकम भी बढ़ रही है, यू कैन मैनेज द इन्फ्लेशन। बट इफ योर लाइफस्टाइल एक्सपेंस इज ग्रोइंग 20-25% every year, then definitely you will find yourself in trouble. We help in contingency planning, family cover for uncertain contingencies like illness, financial problem, death, asset insurance, etc. I'll take 2 more minutes, okay, and discuss key benefit of CFP financial plan construction. One which is very close to my heart, it is known as an alpha and gamma return. तो मुझे को बताएगा व्हाट डज मीन अल्फा रिटर्न? एनीवन वुड लाइक टू शेयर? यस मनीष,
सो ओवर एंड अबव बेंचमार्क,
ओवर एंड अबव द बेंचमार्क। यस राहुल जी, आपने बताया था। अभिषेक, आपने व्हाट इज द अल्फा रिटर्न? यस एनीवन
सर, जो हमारे फंड का रिटर्न है उससे हमारे कितना कैश रिटर्न?
ओके, हायर देन द बेंचमार्क रिटर्न। सो इन लेमन टर्म्स आई कैन से दैट कि सपोज BSE 100 return is 12% last 10 year example, and my return, my means my mutual fund or my portfolio return is let's say 14%. So there is a difference of 2%, so I can say it is an alpha additional return, which is a 2%. Benchmark return is 12%, my portfolio return is 14%, so 2% is the alpha. So So alpha is the excess return, and again in technical term it is known as a risk adjusted. If you are taking a 2% return by taking excessive risk, then it is not useful. So it is known as a risk adjusted return. So when you invest in good quality mutual fund scheme or when you invest in good stock, you can generate the alpha. Second is the gamma. Gamma talks about the financial advisor role. Today if I invest in mutual fund, okay, let's say 1 lakh rupees, fund manager doesn't know what is my allocation to a mutual fund, equity mutual fund. It could be a 1%, it could be 100% also. But if fund manager, if financial planner comes in place and you understand that you have a total asset of 10 lakh rupees and you are only exposed to 10% only, and your goals are all long term goal, then you should expose to how much? 70 to 80%. So by doing the right asset allocation, what happened that you help client to invest 70-80% into the equity asset class instead of the debt asset class. Now what happened that debt return will be known as a gamma return. Earlier average return was example 10%, and now it is a, let's say, 13% return. So that 3% is with help of the financial advisor effort. So today when you talk about the certified financial planner, they talk about the alpha and gamma return to their client. We also help client to do a proper asset planning. It is known as a smooth transfer of asset to a next generation. Tax planning, philanthropic planning. So our objective is to provide the peace of mind, happiness, and more time to the family. Debt planning, already I have discussed in little detail. So lifestyle expense, always happiness feeling, I can afford it but not buying because I have a commitment for goals. Suppose one of your friend has one fancy bike, you can afford it, but even though you don't have, because I don't want, because I have a different goal in which I know that how much fund is required in future. So even I can afford it, but I consciously not investing or not, you can say, buying a luxury product which may not require for me. Freedom from comparison with others. As we know that when we live in society, there is a chance of comparison. But when you know that what are my goals, if I might follow my goals, then I need not to worry about the comparisons. I can reduce my debt systematically. Buying a new loan as per the need. Okay. Example, one can think, okay, when I saw first time BMW or Mercedes-Benz 5 to 10 years before, one felt happy, unhappy. But today, I doesn't make any difference then, because it is not my goal. My goal is maybe different. So if my Mercedes-Benz or BMW is not my goal, then shall I find any different in my heart when I see the Mercedes-Benz or BMW? Because I know that I am earning X income, and to earning that X income, I have a Y surplus, and from Y surplus I have to achieve this kind of goal in my future. Can plan for important goals of family. Happy to fund good EMI. We know SIP is known as a good EMI. Every month to achieve the need based and want based goals. So this is I can say introductory presentation about the what is CFP certification, curriculum of the CFP certification, benefit of CFP certification. I already introduced the participants, speakers, participants. Any quick query, questions you would like to ask? Anything, one or two questions if you have, otherwise we can move to the our first presentation. Sandeep ji, any questions? Okay, so I invite Sanjay Gupta, one of our first speaker, to share his journey.